And one more type of classification of these polymers, as this is, we can consider it as fourth type of classification, classification of polymers based on molecular interactions or interactions. Classification based on interaction or molecular forces. Interaction or molecular forces. That means, let us connect the two types of classification, that is classification based on structure, classification based on molecular forces. Here, generally, the polymers are based on the structure. Polymers may be open chain model or cross-linked model or branched chain model. Here, in this branching, the two polymer chains may be connected with each other. Means one chain is attracted by another chain via covalent bond or hydrogen bond or Vareval interactions. Hence, it is called as this, such type of classification is called as molecular forces. Here, these molecular forces can play the most important mechanical properties of polymers, like tensile character, rigidity, stiffness, toughest, etc. So all these characters of polymer depends upon molecular forces only. Based on the molecular forces, the polymers are classified into four types. They are, first one, elastomers. Elastomers. Second one are Ishwar. Okay, sir. Second one are fibers. Third one thermoplastic polymers, and fourth one thermosetting polymers. So the four types of polymers, what are these classification? This classification is based on molecular forces present in this. What are elastomers? Elastomers are seems to be a rubber type of solids. Here, these the type of molecular forces present in elastomers are weak binding interactions, weak binding interactions present in this polymers. Due to presence of weak binding interactions within the polymers, they are like elastic character, okay? They are not rigid in character, they are with elastic character. Elastic character. So while we are going to free that elastomer type of polymers, they again get same structure. So example is like rubber, when we are going to apply force on rubber, we can elongate the rubber, the volume of rubber, whereas if you free that, then the rubber will again get the similar type of shape like vulcanized polymers. They are like vulcanized polymers. They are with elastic nature. Example for these are neoprene. So we can consider it as CH2CCl, double bond CH2 taken N. So this type of polymers are example for elastomers, whereas come to fibers. Here, fibers are also nothing but one within the molecule, which type of molecular forces can play most importantly in fibers are hydrogen bonding, comma, van der Waal interactions. Van der Waal interactions are present in fiber type of polymers. So these fibers are useful to make some instruments. They are useful to make some instruments in the laboratory or instruments in the daily life. Here, these are having in different modules. Example for fiber category polymers are nylon 6,6 is an example for fiber type of polymers. Come to thermoplastic polymers. Actually, these thermoplastic polymers are nothing but they are like linear polymers. They are like linear polymers with a little amount of branchings. That means thermoplastic polymers are those, they seems to be linear polymers but having some little amount of branchings expected to present with thermoplastic polymers. Generally, these thermoplastic polymers upon heating they become soft ends, upon cooling they become hard ends. That means by changing the temperature, the character of thermoplastic polymers are also become changed. Example for this category polymers are PVC. What is PVC here? Polyvinyl chloride. We can show it as CH2CCl taken N. So PVC stands as an example for thermoplastic polymer. So the structure of this is CH2CHCl taken N. Here I don't want to write example structure of nylon 6 is because just now we completed the structure of nylon 6,6. And come to thermosetting polymers. The thermosetting polymers are seems to be rigid and with high amount of branchings. Upon heating, the molds are going to open in thermosetting polymers and they are very rigid. They are not recyclable. That means thermoplastic polymers we can use or we can recycle them, but thermosetting polymers are not at all used. If we use one time, it is not possible to use second time. So these are the type of polymers are called as thermosetting polymers. Example for thermosetting polymers.